Wilson ran for re-election in 1916 on the slogan, "He kept us out of war," knowing all the time that probably before his second inaugural, we would be in one. Dwight Eisenhower ran on the premise that only a warrior could know the true value of peace and devoted his farewell speech to warnings about the military-industrial complex, yet spent his presidency escalating the Cold War to immeasurable heights. Our fourth story in the countdown, beware the man who tells you he hates war while he takes you on a guided tour of all the war-related places in his personal history, especially if at the very same time the one place he will not go is the place where 50 of his Senate colleagues of both parties are supporting the new GI Bill. That bill, described as a no-brainer by one of its co-authors, Senator Jim Webb of Virginia, save your puns about why Senator John McCain would not have yet endorsed it then. The presumptive Republican nominee saying, quote, "I have not yet had the chance to examine it carefully. It seems to me that it is a good thing to do, but I haven't examined it with the care it needs, but we obviously need to do something along these lines." But the bill's co-authors, Senator Webb and Republican Senator Chuck Hagel, have been actively pushing the bill for months. McCain's lack of leadership confounding, unless, as noted by Sam Stein of Huffington Post, it is compared to the resistance of the Bush administration. White House officials say the bill gives soldiers too strong an incentive to leave the armed forces and thus would produce low retention rates. But in a statement, Senator Webb says, quote, "This is about providing a fair, deserved benefit to our troops. Based on his own military history and how strongly he, McCain, speaks about the positive contributions of the people who've served, I hope that he will get on board." Joining me now, Air America radio host, MSNBC political analyst, Rachel Maddow. Good evening.
Hi, Keith.
McCain basically selling himself as the would-be war president, and he hasn't looked at the GI Bill yet.
Beggar's belief.
Yes.
The John McCain biography tour is essentially a tour of how the military has given him his worldview. It's his experience as a veteran, the importance of the military to his maturation, mm-hmm. to his worldview, to his values. This is the way that he's choosing to redefine himself for voters ahead of the campaign. And if you think about it, this biography tour ends when he comes home from being a prisoner of war. There isn't more in the biography tour about his time as a politician. He's choosing this as his brand on which he's going to take his candidacy to the voters. But if you are asking the American people to extrapolate from our respect for men and women in uniform and our respect for military service right. to his political future, it beggars belief that you would be somehow unaware of the biggest change in our nation's pledge to our veterans in 50 years.
And what on earth would you be doing standing anywhere near a basic argument from the Bush administration? We can't make things too good for our soldiers when they get home.
Right, exactly. I've interviewed a lot of Iraq veterans about the GI Bill, talking about what are the prospects for its passage? How are we going to get this passed? Who's going to sign on to it? Where's the resistance coming from? And that's the question I ask everybody who I've talked to who's worked on this bill. What's the argument against it? Mm-hmm. What's the resistance? I'd love to hear it because I'd like to help come up with the arguments against it, against that resistance. I think this is so important in terms of our moral commitment to the people who have been fighting these wars. And the only argument against it is this argument from the White House that we can't possibly make things too good for the veterans, because it's better for the country somehow and better for them if we leave them miserable and resourceless so that they have no choice but continued military service.
But the extrapolation of that and everything else and the stop-loss programs and everything else that they've done, and McCain is going to have this fall on him at some point in this campaign,
yeah.
is to say, basically, we want to keep sending these soldiers back into conflict until they get killed, yeah. so we don't have to care for them later. How on earth can you be a veteran and not, you know, raise the middle finger to that, even if it is the president from your own party?
Let alone put forth those policies, put forth that record, and then say, USA, yeah. USA, as if it's a patriotic take on it. You know, Keith, we have something else that's about to happen next week in terms of the outrage of using veterans and using military service and using the armed forces as a political prop.
Mm-hmm.
As you know, Michael Mansour is about to be awarded the Medal of Honor.
Right.
Navy SEAL, who's going to be awarded that because he's going to be awarded posthumously because he threw himself on a grenade.
Yeah, one of like 15 acts in his brief life that
yeah.
deserved that award. Yeah.
Yes, exactly. And his family is scheduled to be given his Medal of Honor, and the White House has scheduled that ceremony for Tuesday. They've scheduled that ceremony as the kickoff event for General Petraeus's congressional testimony on why troops have to stay in Iraq.
And that ties back into this idea that this McCain tour and the Bush administration handling of veterans and the war is the romantic, don't think too deeply about this, you know, the dead are happier dead, even if you want to go to that point, this irrational romanticizing of war. War is a brand name.
Yes, war is a brand name. I mean, John McCain has said, I'm sorry to tell you this, there's going to be more wars. There's going to be more wars. He's put the idea of the next war about bombing Iran to the tune of a beach, to a Beach Boys tune. He's described his own political biography as encapsulated completely by his pre-political life as not only somebody who served honorably in wartime, but who was both the son of a four-star admiral and the grandson of a four-star admiral. His entire story about America and his role in it is about war and is not about the mechanics of taking care of people or fighting it.
Exactly. Yeah. So, Mr. McCain, this administration and the one you're proposing would have left you in the Hanoi Hilton. That's what it boils down to. Yeah. All right.